All right, let's do a medical minute. Who knows what primo non nocere is?
Not me.
Not a flat.
First do no harm.
First do no harm.
First do no harm is one of the Hippocratic oath from medicine. And how does that apply to what we're going to learn about today? It's about oxygen and it's about hyperoxia. It was taught to me, at least in medical school back when, that every chest pain gets received by Mona. Anybody remembers what that means? Morphine, oxygen, nitrogen, yeah. So the oxygen part of it is partially true. It's actually wrong in most cases. Why is that? Right, if they don't need it, you don't give it. So who needs it? So anybody with oxygen less than 92%, okay, put on some blow by oxygen, but never try to go over 94%. So hyperoxia is defined by PaO2s of 60 to 65, so anything more than that. And hyperoxia can induce a number of problems, and it has been shown to increase morbidity and mortality in patients with acute MI. It increases reinfarction rates and the whole area of infarction. So if you're the patient having MI, you think oxygen's better. It is not, unless you're hypoxic, in which case you do give oxygen. In stroke cases, it increases the area of stroke. And you wonder, well, why is that? Oxygen induces free radicals. It gets rid of antioxidants, which are good in the body. So having all this extra oxygen gets rid of these antioxidants, and then develop these problems. In a healthy patient who's put on 100% O2, from the time they get to the ambulance to the time to get here, 20 minutes, healthy patients can already have evidence of atelectasis. And atelectasis is those micro collapse of the alveoli, which can induce chest pain, can induce shortness of breath, and can make him have cough and pleurisy. So a normal patient who's put on 100% blow-by can have those changes. Imagine what that does in the chronic COPD-er who is normally hypoxemic, and you put them on 100% oxygen. It's not a good thing. So absorbent atelectasis is the first thing you get bad from hyperoxia. Also, the hypercarbia. These patients, COPDs more specifically, are used to high CO2 levels and low oxygen levels. By putting them on oxygen, you decrease their thrive to breathe because, oh, I'm feeling good, I got all this extra oxygen. They hypoventilate and their hypercarbia worsens. And we know about this and not to do that kind of thing. It can induce airway injury itself. In patients that are healthy, put on 100% oxygen over 24 hours, will have hyperemia of their airway, will have inflammation, and can even induce bronchospasm and bronchial injury. On little babies, we know that they can induce retinopathy. So that we used to put babies on 100% oxygen. We don't do that anymore because they can get blind, basically, from too much oxygen. So again, unless they're hypoxic, 92 or less, don't put patients on oxygen. Primo non nocere, just don't. First do no harm. And that's the medical minute.
Very much.